What's up, YouTube gang? It's been a while. It's been about 2 weeks, and I am back. She's back. I'm mad. Big Mac. Nah, 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 ha, 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 Just in case you're wondering, I do not have a new haircut. This is just me trying to work with the extremely long hair I have before I get to go back to my barber. It does look kind of good though, don't it? And that's the soft love right there, people. But today, you guys, I do want to touch on a topic of new growing pain as I'm going through this journey of becoming a content creator, TikToker. Don't worry to say, but it's the growing pains of dealing with not hate comments, just comments in general, whether they're good or bad. So we're gonna head on over to the comment section of TikTok so we can both react to the best, top, wholesome comments and of course, the most troll ones as well.
TikTok comments with David.
I absolutely love this video. I love doing these skits. So the top comment on this video is by I Drink Listerine. She says, CEO of Wholesome Content. Now I have been getting a lot of comments about wholesome content and that's really cool that this was a top comment. And then right under that comment, Gemini.apologist says, you make me want to get my photo taken, which is saying a lot because I would rather die than be in any picture ever, lol. And as a photographer, this comment does really make me sad as photography is such a simple thing, but to hear people are going through so much pain through that or so much struggle makes me really sad. Whether it's from the photographer doing a terrible thing or just people not being able to see beautiful photos of themselves. And it's especially harder in 2020 with social media everywhere and us getting influence from all around the world. Beauty standards always changing, always getting stricter. And even if we say, oh, don't compare yourself, it's hard unless you totally detach yourself and become a monk somewhere in the woods. This influence is all around us. And even if we try to close our mind to it, we can't. That's what advertising is, right? We're just shown it in front of us. And we can't do much about it, so it's hard. And I come with empathy for that because I understand, again, how much pain that they can go through when they're taking photos. But moving to my third video, this posing video is what like really blew up. It was my first million viewed video. It was absolutely crazy. DannyDina7 says, your movements were smoother than melted butter. This was just so funny because in the whole comment section, everyone was talking about me being a dancer or me reminding them of a flight attendant. See, Shut the Pup Up says, I had the volume off and thought this was a dance tutorial. Come shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Come on, shake your body, baby, do that conga. No, you can't control yourself any longer. Someone did say, I deleted it just because of the amount of attention it was getting. They said, you are a she-male or something like that. So you know what, I just ended up deleting it. I didn't want to see it. Yeah, that was one of my first few run-ins with a troll comment. It was something about that. I don't think people are used to seeing a guy showing how to pose for a woman. They might have seen me act more feminine. And I think that's a big thing in America, right? As we talk about toxic masculinity. I was talking to a client who studied sexuality in college and she was talking about how in Asia, men are more gender fluid. There is problem with masculinity in Korea, like gender roles more so, but it's very different from sort of the toxic masculinity we might talk about in America. And so I can see how me showing feminine poses, maybe even some movements too, might throw a lot of people off in America. First, it hurted. I think there's also a part of me where it's like, almost like that insecurity part where it's like, no, I'm just a dude, I'm a straight dude. But like, why do I have to feel like I have to defend myself? But yeah. Moving on to the fourth video. All right, my dudes, this one is for you. Posing Fundamentals for Men. This is the Posing for Men video I did just because of the sheer amount of men asking poses for guys. And it's so weird because 15% of my audience are dudes. But they're one of the loudest people, dude. Like the 15% really speak up. Then I get this comment by Kenzo Riffick. Who's this Asian dude? My Asian brother. Okay, he comments, first, get a good camera, that's it. I clap back right away and say, camera quality does not make you pose better.
I surprised myself in thinking, oh, it's 2020. People should know better. It's not even about taking good photos. It's just about how to pose well. The camera is not even in the plate. But this guy says, get a good camera. Camera is just camera. There's more pixels. I don't know what else a camera does. There's so many more elements to a good photo. It's like saying to draw really well, you just need a great $1,000 pen.
Sell me this pen.
Which I don't need to make the argument for. And I love this comment by Tom Powell. He says, okay, but I'm also taking the woman's poses too because it's 2020 and IDC and the emoji. And I absolutely love that. More dudes who aren't just about being toxic and masculine at the same time. You don't have to be all buff and do this and commanding and demanding to be masculine. There's so much more to it. So thank you, Tom. Thank you, Tom. And yes, 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 yes. Slenderman Vibes comments, eh, disagree on a lot. Being able to pose feminine is so dope. And Slenderman just pretty much expands on that, like I said. In Korea, you see billboards and like advertisement, big printouts of men in the beauty commercial. Men looking all feminine, all dewy, they got the makeup and everything, makeup routine. Guys are selling skincare routine stuff. And as a Korean dude, I understand that. We can straddle the line between masculine and feminine, and we're okay with that. Only in America is it so much about being big, being tough, not being open emotionally. So Slenderman, I agree. I think it is super cool. I think it shows another dimension to a guy. Anyway, we're gonna move on to sitting poses for women. Let's see what we got here. Feel awkward taking photos sitting down and feel like it's high school portraits all over again? Channel your inner queen and voila. One of the most liked comments on this one is by MTLD String. What about less elegant poses and more lighthearted poses? Because to be honest, not all of us have that much queen energy to look that damn good. If a little does the sweat emoji. The thing is with poses, I see poses as not so much posing your body. It's about what are we expressing? What are we expressing? If I'm over here, okay, and let's say I pose something like this. This isn't something I would do at a bar. Maybe if I'm with another lady, maybe I took them on a date. Maybe if they're really interested, they're looking at me that way. I don't know. But it's about expressing. What does the posture express? I could be sitting like this, and I could be looking at you, I'm like, shoot, okay, all right. But I could be here laughing too. I could be here laughing too. You know, so posture, the body is just the one part, right? And then now you need to add the emotion. Mrs. Koala Puffs comments, yes, but straighten your back. All right, people. Yes, we could be all Asian proper family like this. This also very much is like high school portraits. You sit, 45 turn, swivel your head around, straight back, and then you have mom in the background, David, straighten your back. You know, and like, yes, mom, I'm trying to take the picture. And then you're like this, and then ah, and then they take the photo, okay? There is a place and time for straighter back. This has a very sort of royal king, queen kind of vibe. And that works. There also is a place for hunched backs. If I'm doing a fine art type of portrait, I have my clients in some whimsical flowers and stuff, and I want to sort of do a different emotion. Maybe I want to make the pose a little bit more feminine, closed off, a little bit more shy, not so I'm in your face. Then I might have them go scrunch the back just a touch. We don't always as humans go around like this, okay? Yes, it's good for our posture, but when we communicate, we use our bodies. Okay, when we're shy, we do this. When we're scared, we do this. Okay, we're not gonna be like, oh, yes, I'm scared. Oh, I'm shy, you know?
Okay.
We'll go to the next video. Oh, and this I absolutely loved making. This was a client reaching confidence level over 9,000. This is so funny because it really does happen in real life. And when I make TikToks, what I do is really, this is what happens in my studio. Angie Pasmino commented, your videos have convinced me to leave my boyfriend and live in your work area just to watch you do shoots. Angie, please don't leave your boyfriend. Unless, I don't know, if you're even already having this thought, maybe you should? I don't know. I don't know how to feel about this. Is it a maybe she just said it in a joking way as a compliment, as a creative compliment, but don't leave him. Rethink about this. Something I'm realizing is that as I've amassed close to 500,000 followers and this many likes and this many stats, people no longer see me as a human. People see me by the numbers. They see me as an account. They see me as @DavidSa. They start to build the perception of what this channel is and what @DavidSa is, what and not me. People are championing me as the guy who is all positive, all loving. They think I have no flaws, all wholesome. And these are never things I gave to myself. And I am not. I am absolutely not flawless. I have so many flaws. Only three things I'm good at in this world out of a million things that you can be good at. It's photography, dance, and volleyball. Okay, and maybe some empathy. Everything else I'm bad at. I'm not the best at laundry. Ooh, the truth comes out. I'm also not this person that you're championing me as, or this icon, this beacon of something. There's this little tiny drama that happened. This one person said, if you want Lizzo's help and you're creating monetized content, you need to do things the right way. First of all, who is making monetized content here? Who, what? I'm making monetized content? How do you know that in the first place if I am? She comments back to that saying, oh, I'm sorry. I just assumed all people with this amount of following make money off of their content. And that's really where I realized people start having assumptions. And that's really where I started understanding this concept that at a certain point, people start seeing you as something else, not human anymore. I mean, they understand I'm a human, but they assume, they expect. And then I say, oh, David, you represent so much more. You shouldn't be doing this way. Why are you talking about it this way? I made the video posing for curvy women.
Dave, we're going over how to pose for my curvy ladies, especially if you feel insecure about your arms appearing too big.
And from the beginning, I had some friction of making this video. I knew the whole body positivity community, the curvy community, it's a sensitive topic. Even with Adele's article coming out about her losing weight, there was a whole drama with that. I bit the bullet and I just made it. The top comments with 13,000 likes by Una Kolevetsia, sorry I butchered it, commented, I appreciate how it's not about hiding, but it's more focused on how to look proportioned. People like Herb_rules comment, so still trying to change your appearance to be conventionally attractive. As we live in this world of constant influence of beauty standards and all that, okay, it's not my job to deconstruct what we're influenced by, how a beauty standard that we might have might be toxic or whatsoever. That's a therapist's job. If my client comes to me and says, David, for once I want to look beautiful in my photo, I'm not going to sit there, wave a magic wand and say, your how many years of influence are just gone. I'm here to work as a photographer. Whatever creative vision they have, not all curvy women want to be photographed the same way. Some curvy women are just really confident about their body. Most of my clients are not confident. They're very insecure about how they look. So if they come to me and say, David, I want to look like a fairy, shoot, I'm going to make them look like the best freaking fairy they've ever seen. At the same time, if they want to look slimmer, I'm going to help them with that. If they want to look larger, which typically hasn't happened at the studio, I'm not going to say anything against that either. Our path and our journey of beauty is long and it's independent of everyone else. If you need to go through some phases of being conventionally beautiful and following that path, that's a part of your journey, right? And so this person to come in here and say, oh, still trying to be conventionally beautiful, rubbed me off the wrong way. So yeah, lots of thoughts, you guys, lots of thoughts. Anyway, hope you guys really, really, really enjoyed this video. Like, comment, share. If you want to support me, go to my merch store and have a fabulous day.